Hey Madari, how's it going? Back at it again. Playing too much Cyberpunk? I was just playing Cyberpunk. I'm trying to grind my street cred to 49. I can get the best cyber deck. Yeah, I've been enjoying it. There are some funny moments where I'm running and all of a sudden I die because I like flee face plant into the ground and then die from fall damage even though I was just running across some stuff. Usually happens when you're running across like garbage bags. It is. I feel like the kind of stuff, the kind of environment design is what is missing in Exanima. This needs a bit more dirt. We need more dirt in the game. We need more trash bags. I mean, we already have the random phallic instruments lying around. Did I suffer any funny bug? Yeah, well, besides the one that I talked about where when you're running, you can sometimes face plant and then insta-gib yourself. Yeah, I experienced the cop one. Everyone knows about the teleporting cops. Oh, you know what's a really good one? This one's actually a bit useful if you know how to use it right. So if you're running at the right angle alongside like a long strip of geometry. So if there's like a wall and you're running on top of the wall, if you run at a certain angle, you massively increase your speed. It feels like you're skating. You're basically like skating on thin ice. That's what it feels like. But you can go really fast, just on foot. Yeah, next time you find like a really long strip of like wall or I don't know, like trim. Try running on top of it and then like move side to side until you find the sweet spot. Then you'll notice like a really big increase in your speed. Now, if I had to guess, this is because probably because of how maybe velocity or like running is calculated. So wait, it probably gives you your base speed if you're running on like a flat ground, but maybe if you're running on two pieces of geometry at the same time, it sort of like amplifies it somehow. Either that or the character. Like your character is trying to grab onto the ledge, but since it's failing, I really don't know actually. It's gotta be along those lines somewhere. One that's less fun, a bug that I found is sometimes enemies don't take damage at all until you're within a certain distance. Like you have to trigger certain events before you can deal damage to the enemies that are in the event. I don't like how if you go too far, you'll just get a message that says there's nothing out here for you yet. It seems like kind of a, I don't know, kind of like a cop out. Bit of a lazy design, but I understand why they did it. Like for instance, in games like Morrowind, you're on an island, so you don't really question the fact that you can't swim all the way to the mainland. It's not like anything, any tangible barrier. It's just a message that pops up saying, oh, you can't go this way. Kind of takes you out of the immersion. Why is this stream age restricted? I don't know. It's age restricted. We gotta check OBS settings. I don't know how to check OBS settings. Oh well. It's probably a good thing that's age restricted. I should probably leave that on. You had your car spawning and blowing up the nearby cars. That's awesome. You have like a portable bomb. That's weird. Hacking in the game is so busted. It's so powerful. I've been playing on ultra hard and I hardly ever get hit. I just drop enemies before they can even see me. Coffee Dare sound as if update was ready to roll. Well, I mean, It always sounds like it's ready to roll. I think we're in that phase where it's very close to being ready to roll, to ready to ship, but then it's also not at the same time. And maybe yeah, just take that with a grain of salt. There's a lot of back-end work to be done. Well, that is being done, especially in regards to materials. Doing a pistol revolver Netrunner crafting build. Yeah, I think for like the past 10 hours or so of me playing the game, I've just been farming street cred. So it's just a lot of knocking enemies unconscious with net hacks and then capping him in the head with a silenced pistol. It feels very very like evil. I feel like V might not be a protagonist in my playthrough. Probably just the whole thing emerge. Did I complete the socks? Do I want a hinge here? I think I do. Go add a hinge here. Set this off. Art, more like fart. How's it going, Marks? How's it going, Yigfald's Fury? I went to this really nice restaurant for lunch earlier today. Like really good, like proper high-end fancy schmancy food. There is really good, very tasty. That'll work. That'll do, pig. Where is my I gotta organize my tools. I have like two copies of this. Go do file size 13. Click and drop. Might need to cut back a bit more metal. Gotta say, this texture material is awesome. Oh, are you looking at the screenshots from the coffee diary? They are pretty good, aren't they? Not today's coffee diary, but I think they're. Or are you in like the insider chat? Because I know they passed around screenshots of those there. Look even better in game. Oh, this here, this is actually ZBrush. This doesn't relate with anything that's an engine. Like it's like a third party program. Whoa, I'm sorry there. Shoot, I almost broke NDA by talking about the Insider Channel. Whoopsies. I think get rid of a few more pulleys here. Yeah, that looks right. About right. All right, now we can actually you're asking if Maddox material would look better than the metal material used. Yeah. This actually isn't even a texture. It's just a material capture, a ZBrush material capture. That's why they're called matte caps. Wait, what the heck? Oh, Z intensity is zero. That's why. I'm wondering why isn't my brush working? Oh wait, we're supposed to divide this too. Wow, I am not paying attention right now. me divide this. Now we'll group loops. Alt F4 for secret special ZBrush option. Shoot, that just closed ZBrush. What the heck, man? I'm kidding. I just toggled the window. Guys should have seen the look on your faces. Counter net hack. good one though. Dude, I should have I need to here first. Gotta shrink this down. We got to add a rim. The rim job I forgot to add. What's this? This doesn't look right. God, why is everything has to have to mess up? Right, I think this brick. How do people actually fall for the Alt F4? At least these days. I can understand, like, in the early days of the internet. We gotta get rid of this triangle. Yeah, we can do that. Alright. Now we can merge everything finally. Take this by one. Tree divide. You want to see something truly horrendous? Nygwald's Fury. I'll show you something that will probably scare you. Look at this. It's like a sphere. It's a sphere made out of triangles. There's not a single quad on this baby. It's just spheres. Oh my god! Like smooth it out into existence. Gone. Pretty scary stuff. ZBrush is preem. Pretty preem, yo. These. Okay, I went around the edges, but I forgot the middle. The Gothic Gauntlet has a tail. I wonder if we can just mask this and stretch it. Let's save this out of work if we do this. This is something like that. I know, it smiles. Smiles the MS Kitty. I wish I could poop. Been constipated for a while. Be nice to have some bowel movements right about now. EM. BM Games. Challenge everything. Remember when EA had that slogan? EA Games challenge everything? Well, now it's BM Games. Everything. All right, later, Mercs. Have a nice brunch. Be up games, Bart. Add some flutes in here. Hopefully we can just do this in ZBrush. Although I might switch over to Modo if we. I might actually just be able to fix everything here with CModeler. Not use ZBrush at all. Try it. Oh, I should probably do. I should probably try serum. Serum, I sure. If Bare Metal had like a different slogan other than like the, you know, like the introduction title where it's Madoc making gremlin or goblin sounds. Like the heh. I wonder what it would be besides fart jokes. Visible polys. Very interesting. What if it was like the sound of a espresso machine? You'd have like that ch sound of a that nice hissing noise of a freshly made espresso. Or at least how I imagine an espresso machine sound like, because I don't actually own one. Someone drugged the cat. Nobody drugged the cat. He's always drugged. This is he is. You guys know that the fake cartoon from Homer and Sim from The Simpsons, like Itchy and Scratchy? The cat in that cartoon is who I imagine Zulix or Smoils to be. I don't know if it's Zulix or Smoils. He seems to be using Smoils more often than not. It's either Smoils, Zulix, happening. Or Atheros. It just works. Madoc actually does say it just works sometimes. He actually says that sometimes. I think it must be like a programmer lingo. Be like secret programmer code for something. I mean, if like Todd Howard says it, and also Maddox says it, then something fishy is going on. Guess this works means automated. Does it though? Like if it's automated, then who's doing the automation? Thought about that. No end of trouble. I should really just do the low poly in Modo. Okay, that better. No, it's not better. Oh my god. Oh my god. What an actual pain. Why do people call it a buttocks? Like you have a butt and you have an ox. Where did they combine the two? One is a big animal, the other is your behind. The buttocks stream now, Veltex. Gotta keep up with the times. Like imagine if you're walking down the street minding your own business and all of a sudden a buttocks comes up to you and like like they accost you, they stick a gun at your face, and then they're like, hands up, give me all your money. And then like Veltex would be like, yo, what? I didn't know this is I didn't know buttocks were in this world. Yeah, you gotta keep up with the times, otherwise, the time will go on without you. Oh my god, fuck my life. It's like the worst geometry ever. I really should have just done this in Modo. I can't believe I'm tinkering around this long with this stupid piece of metal. I see something else there, but caught myself. All right, this is fine. This is good enough. That it's fine meme. The one with spoils burning. Epcot. I should subdivide this. Wow, I am really not things the right way today. Yeah, I just realized why what the problem with anti-vaxxers are. They're afraid of getting injected. They're afraid of ejaculation. Now let's go make a hinge right across here. Suppose we can use. Right, we're just gonna make our own hinge. I really need to make some insert hinges. Not acceptable that I don't have any. Let's just go use some initialize. We'll just do this hinge in. Whoa. Wrong mesh. Do this initialize. How about like 3 instead of 2? No, we gotta stick with the numbers. I don't like the look of that. Better. Gonna make a quick and easy lemon squeezy hinge. Get kind of small. A small hinge. Detail you guys will barely even notice. An important one. Oops. Go delete. Insert multiple edge loops. So I want to split this into 3. That in half. This. Cylinder, the end game boss. This is a spoiler stream after all. Be a spoiler if I didn't show you guys the end game boss. Right, let's duplicate this. We will duplicate again. We'll have this one as backup copy. This one will be the perspective. Actually, effective. Let's go. Like loops. Rev. One. Ask here. Search that one out. This one, we'll do the same here. We'll just like loops that. Ask this portion that way instead. Then get rid of, well, like that group. That with these two pieces over here, get rid of that. Now we have a simple hinge. I want this to curl out into a fan, so we'll end. Okay. It's not a pin. We'll just insert some edge loops. Spread this out. Wait, ooh. Mask this, that, increase the mask. Now we will rotate, transform local symmetry, y-axis. That, we have perspective off. Now we can rotate around. This. That could look cool. And one out. Okay. What is this autism that spoils the cat throat? Wow. I expected nothing less. Truly magnificent poetry that spoils the cat has written. Can be kind of asymmetrical, isn't it? A. Whenever I think of asymmetrical, I think of a lmao. Gotta have your memes. Wrong axis. I can probably do something fancy by mirroring the other hinge, but I don't know. I just don't feel very efficient today. Miles could probably wear like a cod piece as a helmet. He's a cat. Just cut two holes, poke two holes in the cod piece. Be able to slip it over his head. They can run around the battlefield as a little penis cat. Like bite everyone's ankles. It'll be horrifying. Later, Madari. That's pretty rough geometry. But once I hit it with group loops, it'll be okay. I think we need to form the basis of this to the other side. read this. Read all polys. That looks that, I guess. Same here. Oh, is this with that? There we go. I think we can. Oops. Good. Again. Bit high poly for such a small detail. That. Or we can just keep it as is. We have to increase poly groups. Yeah, we'll just do that. We won't actually poly groups. Right, devil. Devil. Not very well. Go increase all. We'll select loops. Edge. That. Bevel. There we go. Here. All. This. Oops. Nice. Then we can like I don't know. My normal hinge. Drag it out here. Grab that. This in. The last. Yep. There we have by this. Merge this together with the other bits here. And make this a let's go auto groups first. Let's make this a hinge. So we'll just create insert mesh append. All right, let's save this. Well, so at least I have like some sort of hinge. It's not a really good one, but it'll still work for now. Save this in my startups folder. Now we have that. insert mesh, just insert it here. Go the other way. That. Very nice. Very nice. Actually around look better that way. Long movement still there. Handle not look better. My normal that's 3.5. That is what we did last time, wasn't it? Bed 0 is the wrong hinge. I'll click that. I rotate this position better. That's something that I guess works. Not perfect. But it'll do. Why did I miss that extra line on the inner side of the likings last stream? What extra line? I don't know what you're talking about. Sounds possible for me to miss anything. Like Tarkus would attest that I have not missed anything, any such line. Hey, chat is not displaying on screen. It should be. I mean, chat isn't playing on screen. Oh, it isn't. The heck? What the hey? Try typing something now. That's really weird. Alright, it says chat connected. Nice. Wow, that sucked. Now the recording is just gonna be like me talking to myself for the past hour and a half. So the reason why chat wasn't connected is I'm having issues with my ZBrush license. I'm not sure what's going on, but like the only way I can start up ZBrush is by turning off my Wi-Fi. So it has to be some authentication error. Guys are blind or something. That is, he does have a point, guys. How did you guys miss that? Like that all stream long. It's not my duty to make sure that chat. Well, that I had like Wi-Fi off when I started up OBS. I think that's what broke it. Oh, hey, welcome to the stream, ML Emilari. Don't worry, you didn't miss anything too important. Oh. The heck, this maybe this isn't. Guess it was. I can't really see the well. Fact, no one actually watching your streams. Yeah, I figured. You guys are just here for the fart jokes. It's just like a very juvenile stream now. It's just farts and penis jokes all day long. For 2 hours straight. I subdivide this? I think I should. Or I. Actually, why should merge everything together? By that. It just some flames here. I actually like watching these in your spare time as a beginner in Blender. That's cool. This is a bit hacky and not normally how I would go about making these plates. But sometimes you gotta work outside the box. Gotta work outside the tetrahedron. Best possible medieval armor from modern materials. You probably use like some sort of military alloy. So you probably want like maybe like some sort of like cobalt or I was gonna say depleted uranium, but that's probably a bad idea for armor. Sort of carbide. What's it called? Tungsten carbide or something like that. You want like a tungsten and steel alloy blend. But really, like the best armor, if you were to time traveler, you just grab a rifle, modern assault rifle. There's your armor. What's so good about uranium? Well, depleted uranium is one of the hardest substances. They use it in armor-piercing rounds. Can't craft ammo with a for an assault rifle. You probably could. I mean, it would take some work, making a machine that can stamp out shells. But really, why would you need a suit of armor if you're going time traveling anyway? Just bring like diseases. Just bring diseases with you, and then you won't have to worry about anyone else. Role play as a black knight. Well, you have to be a black man to role play as a black knight. But really, like the best suit of armor for medieval times is probably just a suit of armor made with like the normal steel and forging techniques. Yeah, I mean, like homogenized steel is already a massive advantage compared to, well, compared to like the super high-end steel of medieval times, it's still a few steps better than that. Like high-quality carbon steel, that's been forged into a into the right shape. You can roll a car over it and it'd still keep its shape. Not much changes until you're starting to fight against bullets. Then you'll want to switch to ceramic armor instead, or a blade of armor. Blades of old would break or bend. I don't know about that. I mean, I probably bend or break the same amount against normal medieval armor compared to modern armor. Really, the biggest advantage that homogenized steel has is if it's forged correctly, then you have a much reduced chance of the steel splitting along, like impurity lines. And that's pretty much about it. I suppose you could make it a bit harder if you added could make it a lot better if you had like the perfect forging technique, and also if you case hardened it with a modern thermometer, and if you like used tungsten, sort of alloy with tungsten in it. Or cobalt. That I'm not really too knowledgeable about alloys. But I know there's some pretty powerful, pretty strong modern steel alloys used in military. Why don't you go look up like tank steel, or like look up the specs for modern warfare. Not the game, but I mean like vehicles and stuff. If they have the specs online. I feel like the counters need to be bigger, like a lot bigger. They seem kind of dinky and small. Heard of the gauntlets anyway. There's some scaling that I need to work on. Guess we'll add in the rivets. It's rivets. I try like three. Maybe let's go try 2.75. Yeah. Make a bit of room for the last rivet here. About graphene? I don't know. What about graphene? Graphene's pretty brittle, isn't it? That graphene is really hard but really brittle. Bit like diamond. How many hours do I have on Exanima? About less than 200. Bone armor, eh? I thought that was suggested before. Someone brought it up. Oh. Maybe you brought it up in a previous stream. Can't remember. Bit tight on space here. Bit more. Down here too. Guess I could just use smaller rivets, but then really look as good from afar. Wait, I did. 5. 3.75. I do that all the time. I suggest something and I feel like sometimes I've suggested it before. Might have to use the the intent like 50. We try 34. 34, I guess. Yeah. Let's go try 50. There we go. Update next week? I don't think so. I think you guys are gonna have to wait for a while for the update. It's been next week, like, for a very long time. I wouldn't get your hopes up too high. Like, I want the update out too, but gotta be realistic, you know? That. I really should have just split this out into fingers. I have to deal with. Logical. Nudge it out. Next week, 100%. Quite you, this is how we survive. Oh no. Now Maddox doing like some pretty hardcore materials work. Cross screen. Why do the fingers have to be so close together? That's what I don't like about this human mesh model, base model. Like everything is so close together, you could hardly sculpt on armor onto the character, especially between the fingertips, fingers. Oh my God, this is very tricky. That. Rivets are too big. Never. Rivets are never too big. Maybe here it's a bit too big. I do 1.5 for the pinky. Pinky dinky. Like I have to make them a little bit bigger than IRL, otherwise they won't show up at all. Like if you zoom out all the way out here, the effect that I want to get is just more detail, so it looks more like metal. So it looks really convincing out here. But yeah, if you do zoom in a little bit closer, then the rivets are a tad bit too big. But such is modeling. Got a model for the project. Yeah, I put rivets on everything. There's some rivets on the gloves too. Gauntlets. Want to see something wild? If you think like rivets are small, let me introduce you to C. These fingertips are covered though. You don't have to cover it perfectly because when the player wears gloves, it just replaces the hands. I do want it fairly accurate. Now this one needs to be. Wait. Wrong. Wrong thing. Bam. Yeah, make sure everything mirrored. Okay, that's good. I think some of the later Arena armors have rivets on the fingers. Maybe some of the Underworlder armors. By like one. Size frame by polygroups mode that how about that? How about this? A little bit deeper. There we go. This by 0.5, about 0.25. Okay, that kind of. I don't know, flat sketch, get that color, that be little. With this, we want to cloth details. Wait, did the glove actually inherit the color of? Okay, I want the gloves to be a bit darker. Feel white. So now we have the seams. We use some cloth alphas. Mask thing. Grease the mask. Drag out some wrinkles. Nice little wrinkles. Drag them up here so are in a good place. I want to subdivide this actually. Low poly. Go get some base forms in here first. A brush. Right. That. It's actually not bad, although we could do one subdivision, I guess. Up the areas that are often and in between the thumbs there too. Here. Oops. Only the fingers, we haven't at all. It doesn't look too shabby. Procedural breaks? That. Is that something Madoc wrote into the dev diary? Maybe Madoc lurks in chat. Maybe he's here listening in, like quietly laughing to himself. Ah, I stole the brig idea. Never know. Could just be around here. Just waiting for that opportune moment to strike. That's scary if you think about it. Yeah, laughing at our need for odd pieces. All right. I think the gauntlets are in a good place. Oh wait, we shouldn't do the trim. Let's go add rivets to the trim. We can also move the trim around so it doesn't don't have that edge as well. That one. Bottom side. Oh. Camera snap. Yeah, throw in a few rivets. Draw size, maybe three. How about let's go do 3.75. Let's see intensity. On solo mode. First rivet should go. And then we'll go around from including as guide. The guide. Could probably actually do that better. Here. Half mark. This is too many rivets. All right to me. Never enough rivets. Yeah, I feel like there's a mosquito here. I don't know. Something's buzzing around. Hope it's not a mosquito. I can write in some dev names. Yeah, that's true. I could. I'll just write needs codpiece on the inside of the placard. Is everything in the gauntlets folder? Stuff that's out. Yeah, okay. There's a few bits that are hanging out. Oh wait, that's actually in. Okay. Yeah, we're getting really close to being able to work on the helmet and everything really. What's next? See. I want to make the counters bigger. I don't seem big enough. Merge everything, I guess. Scale it up. I like this shoulders, pauldrons seem to be a bit bigger too. Not like massively big, but I don't see. A little bit bigger. Pauldron. Well, this master. Dealing here. There we go. Proper pauldron. They're a bit small before. Hey, Conrax. Yeah, you arrived just at the tail end of the stream. I think we have like 10 minutes left, and I'm off to meet the Sandman. Ah, Banana Born and Conrax. Wow. Welcome to Horny Jail. Four-hour streamer, right? I have to either stream 24 hours or join Riot Games. Whatever happened to Riot Games? I remember they're huge. I don't really hear about them. Maybe I just don't look in the news often enough. Oh, what we should do is add some buckles here. And next. I'm actually feeling kind of sleepy right now. It's really getting hit over the head with the wave of sleepiness. Man, EA would love me. Like, I know like the best ways to ruin games. I have so much experience, and I've lived through so many ruined games. I can just like help them cut to the chase and just make the worst game ever possible. Like the most predatory monetization strategies ever. I can help them with that. Shoulders are a bit high now. Go, yeah, the shoulders. Like the points are a bit too high, to be a bit lower. Kind of looks like he's scrunching up his shoulders like he's cold or something. Exactly. Every time you press start game, you have to watch a 30-second ad before you can play. I mean, they already have that in mobile games. It wouldn't take a whole lot of work to port it over to PC games. Right, guys? Right. I'm not evil, I'm just reapplying like mobile game logic to PC gaming. Like if they want to make a whole bunch of money, they should stop pussyfooting around and just demand more money by just putting ads on everything. Gamers will still play it because gamers are moshoists. Kind of like gamers as a whole, we're kind of like into BDSM. Like, oh no, stop it! Oh God, it hurts so bad. Keep hitting me more with monetization. All right, guys. I think I should go to sleep before I say more stupid stuff that can potentially get me fired. All right. What do you mean, wait? I gotta go to sleep. Refired. Refried. It sounds like refried beans. What if you return it to refried beans? Like, I don't know, it sounds like some sort of like pizza that you microwave. I don't know. Okay, guys, I'm gonna go to sleep. You guys can watch the recording, but it's pretty bad because I broke the comments box. Yeah. It'll just look like I'm talking to myself the whole time. Yeah. Good night.